Yo, what's up, what's up, what's up, y'all? This your boy Jiggy J, the GOAT of this whole radio shindig. I got my man Phil Jackson of this whole dynasty thing, Mr. Lee Behind the Glass. Thank you, sir, I appreciate you. And then I also got the first lady of Get Loose Radio, Miss Lola Marks.
How you dig?
My ace Boone Coon, how you been?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good, man, I'm good. Important day that we having right about now, yes. At this very moment. Obama is, damn.
Can't even get the words out there. Obama is actually, as we speak right now, giving his farewell address in Chicago. He is on stage right now. We're actually watching him right now. We only got to see half of it. So, you know, the first half is just, you know, thanking people and what we've done so far. We don't hear what he's doing at this point. But he is on stage right now in Chicago giving his farewell address right now.
Yeah, man. Memories of President Obama. I remember when he first got elected. Mm-hmm. I was a sophomore in college at Bowie State University. Shout out to BSU. Mm-hmm. And we find out that he actually won. The whole entire campus lost it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That was a pivotal moment. And you know, in our history, man. And then, not to mention, when he got sworn in, I never forget, my grandfather told me, he said, I never thought I'd see the day that a black man would be in office. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. My man shed a tear, man. Where were you when he first got elected?
When he first got elected, I was actually home. Yeah. Because me and my mom, we went to vote early that morning. We went to work, we came home, and you know me, I'm checking off states as they going through it and everything. And I had fell asleep. Mm-hmm. And I woke up, and as I woke up, they was counting down the 11 o'clock hour when California was bringing in their votes and stuff. And then Wolf Blitzer, I'll never forget it, said, breaking news, Wolf Blitzer comes on and he says, it is official, it has been confirmed that Barack Obama will be the president-elect for 2018. Mm. And I heard my mom scream downstairs. I jump out of bed, I run downstairs, she's crying. I'm like, oh my gosh!
Yeah.
We call my grandma, and you know, for her, she's like, wow. You know, at that point, she was just like, I can't even believe I'm still alive to see the fact that, you know, there was a brother.
Exactly. Because you got to think about it. Our grandparents' generation went through so much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, racism. Yeah. Well, racism's still alive, but the segregation, Jim Crow, you know, civil rights movements and everything. And the fact that he got elected twice, too, that was huge in itself. That was history in itself, man. And now, dang, Obama, man, President Barack Obama, man, thank you. Appreciate everything that you've done for us.
So here's the big question I have, and I'm gonna throw it to you. Here's the biggest question right now. The hope that you had when he was elected in 2008,
mm-hmm.
that came with you being there and everything, is it still alive, or has it diminished a little bit with? I mean, because he ran for two terms, mm-hmm. you know, by law, he cannot run for a third term. So is that hope that was there when Obama first started, mm-hmm. is it still alive today?
First of all, what we have to understand is that it starts with ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it starts with us as a people.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that I kept saying last season was that, you know, it starts with us within our communities. We have to really get out and do what we need to do. Do I feel as though we can still make change? Absolutely. But we still have what we as a people, I'm talking to everybody from communities from Baltimore to, you know, DC to everywhere. It doesn't matter, man. We have to make the change that we want to see.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We can't talk about it. We cannot cry about it.
Mm-hmm.
We have to do what we got to do. If you're not doing anything, I don't want to hear you complain.
Mm-hmm.
You know, voting is very important. Getting people registered to vote, getting these young kids, you know, off the streets and let them know that, hey, look, you can do whatever it is that you want to do, but what you cannot do, you cannot go in the path which is going to lead you to destruction, jail or the grave. You know what I'm saying? So it starts with us. It starts with the mentoring. It starts with really be active in each other's lives, supporting. Like, it's nothing like Black support. Mm-hmm. You know, we got a lot of Black businesses out here. It's nothing like supporting Black businesses, man. Mm-hmm. We can do it.
We
really can do it.
Right.
We just got to put the work in, man. We just got to stay focused. You know what I'm saying? Right. What about you?
For me, I'm going to say no.
Okay.
I'm not going to say that because, okay, when Obama, after his, my hope for me didn't come when he won the election. My hope started when he gave his speech at the 2004 Democratic National Convention.
Mm-hmm.
That was when I first saw him. That was when I first said he might be actually a gold mine to being president.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, from there on, following him in his journey to the presidency was remarkable. And yeah, we know some people voted for him just because he was Black and other people actually, you know, knew what he stood for and everything like that. But everything that has happened over the past 8 years is definitely bittersweet, because in a sense, some of it may go away, some of it may stay. We're not sure. Can it all be reversed? No. But we have to work at it.
Right.
We have to fight for what we want.
Right.
You know, just like the gays, they fight for marriage equality. You know, Jewish people, they fight for financial gain from, you know, everything. And we got to fight for what we want.
Right.
And right now, as a whole, the Black community is not fighting.
I mean, the Black community is not fighting because we fell out. We lost our fight, in my opinion. Some of us lost our fight. Some of us are still trying to keep the fight and keep pushing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We can do it.
We gotta fight.
There's no excuses. We can really do it. The question is, are we gonna put that work in?
Are we going to stand united and stop fighting each other?
Exactly.
And giving the white person what they want. Because that's what they don't have to do anything. We're doing it ourselves.
Exactly.
That's exactly what we do. Every time we diminish ourselves, we, you know, allow people to televise us in a ratchet behavior and everything like that. I mean, it's just all of that goes into consideration when we talk about is the black community united. So what is the still hope still there? Maybe not.
Well, this is what we're going to do. On a lighter note, let's go to entertainment news.
I don't know how light it is right now, but we're going to go to entertainment news. First of all, we are celebrating the 1 year anniversary of David Bowie's death. That was my man. So I'm definitely going to
on my birthday. Yes,
so
sir.
Definitely I'm going to shout him out and everything. So yeah. Definitely he just shared a birthday January 8th and today is his death. So David Bowie and his wife, Iman. Great supermodel. But anyway, moving on to sadder news. Fort Lauderdale Airport came under attack when a man with I don't know what kind of weapon it was, but he had some type of weapon coming off of a airplane, and he fired a whole lot of shots in the air, killing at least 5 people are dead from that.
And he was from what I understand, he was trained military.
Yeah, he checked it in. He checked his bag.
Yep.
And everything. But what people are calling it a terrorist attack, I wouldn't go that far as saying it was a terrorist attack. This man had psychological problems. He said he was hearing voices in his head. That doesn't really connect with terrorists. That just connects with somebody that is having a psychological breakdown. And unfortunately, a lot of people in the Fort Lauderdale Airport came under that attack as well. So prayers about that. And so we keep the families in our prayers as we move on. This next portion, some would call it a lighter note or whatever, but Dylan Roof, the killer of the South Carolina Nine, was sentenced to death earlier today in a federal court in South Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
So he, you know, he represented himself in the courts.
Mm-hmm.
He had no witnesses.
Mm-hmm.
He just wanted to tell everybody that there is nothing wrong with him because they were labeling him as severely and psychologically just done.
Right.
Like he had some issues and everything like that. However, he was keeping a journal while he was in jail.
Mm-hmm.
And he represented himself and he told the court and the judge that nothing is wrong with him. He had to do it. And he feels no remorse for what he had to do. So today he was sentenced to death after being found guilty for 33 counts of hate crime, obstruction of destroying religion and everything like that. So.
So let me ask you, because I already know my answer. If we had the opportunity to switch his death sentence, would you do it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Second question. And I think I'm going to get the same answer as you.
Mm-hmm.
How would you want to handle this situation?
Okay, well, since we live in America, I would just let him live and let him sentence to life and let his ass just sit and rot, just like Charles Manson is doing in jail, period. That's what it is. But if you're ever in Europe or in the Eastern Hemisphere, the way they do it and everything like that, the way their laws are set up, you know, you might get a firing squad.
I tell you.
Exploited live on TV. You know how that goes. So
I tell you.
Yeah, it's just sad. I'm
going to tell you. Take him to the Middle East.
Mm.
Put his ass in a circle. Pause.
Mm-hmm.
Let someone take that machete and slice his head off.
Ooh.
In public.
Ooh.
My thing is this. What was the statement that he made?
He said he had to do it.
Uh-huh.
He did not feel, I'm just paraphrasing at this point. He had to do it. He does not feel any remorse to stop bringing witnesses and family members in there that are giving their emotional speeches. He doesn't care. It's not about him.
Okay, this is what I'm going to do. I don't give a damn either. Let's do it. Let's make it happen.
Because
we're not going to give a damn either. We're going to do exactly what we want to do.
Right.
And we just have to do it.
Right.
It's just that simple, man. I mean, it is what it is.
Bro,
you took 9 innocent lives, man.
Yeah. I don't understand the issue with him or what was going on or anything like that. But truly, he has.
You don't give a damn.
Graciela says stone him. him.
We're going to do it back in biblical terms is what you're saying. Sure. Man, these, it's crazy, man.
Yes, it is. But yeah, so he was sentenced to death and, you know, it'll be years before that man go out. It was just the same way with Timothy McVeigh after the Oklahoma City bombing. It was a while before it actually happened. So he'll actually just sit there. He'll probably be a grown man before all of that happened and everything.
Fuck it.
So on a lighter note, Golden Globes happened this past Sunday and Black Magic was everywhere.
You gotta love Black Magic. You heard 24 karat magic.
Yes.
This is Black Magic at its finest.
I mean, it wasn't just Black girl magic.
Yes.
It was Black boy magic. It was just Black magic, period. Starting with Tressie Ellis Ross winning after 34 years the Best Actress Award in a television comedy or musical. It was phenomenal.
Man,
she looked amazing,
man,
too.
She waited as long as Janet has been waiting to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
I mean, last person to win that was actually Debbie Allen for the TV show Fame.
Yeah.
And everything. So, yeah, I know Debbie Allen is truly happy. Next up was the TV show Atlanta. It
my
won
man.
For Best Television Comedy.
Mr. Glover himself.
Yes, himself, who actually won for Best Actor in a Television Comedy or Musical. Which was amazing.
Have you listened to the man's album?
I have.
Bruh.
I love Childish Gambino's album. You know, I was playing it on the way here, and I just love his music, period. It's got that Parliament
Funkadelic. Yes. Zombies?
And
really?
I love Funkadelic. Like Redbone? Redbone's one of my favorite hits on that album. Zombies, but yeah, he won Best Actor. And then for on the movie side, Viola Davis won for Hidden Fences. I'm so sorry.
Don't do that. Don't do that. When that lady interviewed Pharrell about that, and she said, "How you? What, there's some sense of Hidden Fences." I was like, "Wait, what?"
And then Michael Keaton gets up there, Octavia Spencer for Hidden Fences. What? Hidden Figures.
Crazy.
Ridiculous. Man. And then last but not least, Moonlight won for Best Picture. Obama is crying. He's doing a tribute to Michelle Obama. I'm gonna have to rewind this. We gotta do the show right now. So Moonlight won for Best Picture on the drama side.
Okay.
For it, have you seen Moonlight?
I have not seen Moonlight.
Moonlight is actually a very, very good movie. It shows a connection between a guy who is growing up. And he's dealing with these issues of his sexuality, but more so it came through as he was dealing with more issues of his mother being on drugs, him living in, as they say, ghetto life, mm-hmm. all this other stuff, and being bullied throughout the first, half of his year. And then he grows up and he becomes this trap mogul. And he's still dealing with the same issues that he was dealing with when he was a kid.
So he needs to face his issues head on.
Exactly.
That's what you're saying.
People think that Moonlight is such the gay movie, but it really wasn't. It really dealt with all of his childhood and all of his issues that he is having and that he faces with everything. Do I think it was Best Picture? No, I didn't, unfortunately.
What you think?
I wanted Hella High Water to win.
Because everybody in that movie was nominating it. Why the hell not?
Hella High Water was a great movie that was nominated. It stars Chris Pine and I believe, I think his name is Jeff Bridges, if I'm not mistaken. But Hella High Water, is about a family who is dealing with their own issues of, trailer park and trying to get money, but they're thieves. They're bank robbers. So it is a good movie, and I think that was about. I didn't like Manchester by the Sea. Didn't really care for it. But Hella High Water was my pick for Best Picture. So we'll see how that goes with Emmys coming up and with the Oscars and everything. So people are mad right now. TGIT. Thank God it's Thursday. Absolutely. Scandal, Grey's Anatomy, How to Get Away with Murder. Uh-huh. All of them were supposed to come back next week, January 19th, with their premieres for the winter season.
Okay.
However, they are being delayed a week because the First Family, the Trumps, goes to Washington, is actually airing a special at that time. So all of the shows that were on ABC are going to be delayed 1 week now because his special will be put in that segment on ABC.
I want to see that shit. How to Get Away with Murder. Yeah. Hell, I watch Grey's Anatomy too. Shit.
I love Grey's Anatomy.
Yo, that's my joint. You put on the dumbest First Family for you two. Hold on. I got to give credit when credit's due. Mm-hmm. You disrespectful bastards. You mean to tell me I got to sit there and watch... I can't stand his ass. Watch a motherfucking bigot with a damn toupee on do his travel to the White House and shit.
Yes.
Man, got me. Man, oh my God.
Yeah, I'm hot too, Janae, because, I love me some TGIT and they delaying it another year and another week and it's really just pissing me off. But,
just pissed me off.
Yes,
what the hell am I supposed to do with my Thursdays now?
Well, you only got one more week to wait. It's just one special. Being Mary Jane was actually delayed an hour because Obama's speech is on right now.
Okay, that's different. It's Obama.
Both of them are presidents. So, they get the same
respect. No. This is President Barack Obama. He will always be President Barack Obama.
Okay.
This motherfucker, that's Donald Trump.
No, he does not get my respect. I understand.
I mean, it is what it is. He's the president, whatever. But man, Y'all, yeah. Let's just pray.
It's
y'all, okay. Please.
It's all right. One more week will not hurt us. TGIT will air the week after next. Trump will be
speak
on.
For yourself.
So don't. I mean, I miss it too. I'm definitely excited because Scandal is back.
Yo, this won't be crazy.
This is the first time this it's
gonna
be been crazy. Back since.
This won't be crazy.
Like around this time last year. So I'm really excited about that.
So just right now. Scandal's gonna be crazy, and then How to Get Away with Murder.
Man. From what I hear, the first 10 minutes of Scandal, if you miss it, you miss it all. So
yep, that's it. Yeah,
so definitely tune in for that.
So next Thursday, I already know where I'm gonna be. The Etnies. You dig.
Gosh, we got a lot of entertainment news today. Yes. Moving on, Chris Brown and Soulja Boy. Everybody knows that they have been cackling back and forth to each other. The last thing that I saw was Chris Brown cussing him out because Soulja Boy said something about his daughter and being around his daughter, hanging out with Karrueche and all that other stuff.
Okay.
Anyway, it has been confirmed that these two little heathens are going to be fighting each other in Dubai on pay-per-view.
First of all, I'm not even gonna ask the question who's gonna pay $69.95 to see this fight.
Oh, I have a website on my computer that I watch.
Okay, because I'm not even gonna lie.
I'm not paying.
I'm not even gonna lie. I kinda wanna see this fight too.
Who
just for entertainment purposes.
Who you got?
I got Chris Brown. Mike Tyson is training him, okay? The baddest man on the planet is training one of the baddest dudes on the planet as well.
But okay, but
don't take no shit from nobody.
Floyd Mayweather is training Soulja Boy, right? So how can you hit something that's gonna dance around you? Because that's exactly
trust
how
me.
Floyd has
trust
the
me.
Money team
trust
has
me.
Got all around
trust me.
Him.
Let me pause this, and I'm gonna be wrong when I say this. Uh-huh. I don't condone domestic violence. But you saw the picture. That's all I'm going to say. Now, continue. That's all I'm going to say. Continue. Who you going to go with? You going to go with a fucking crackhead? You going to go with someone who knows how to whip somebody's ass?
I've seen the
like I said, hold on, pause. Hold on, pause. WTTS Radio does not condone or express any whatever. You read the tagline in the beginning of the show. You know we don't condone domestic and all that other crap. The views of this radio show has not been expressed. You know the rest of it.
Fresh said he's ordering it, so yeah.
Oh, she party at Fresh House.
Everybody
then. Go to his Fresh House. Fresh, where you live, dog? I'll bring the drinks. You provide the food and the pay-per-view, and my thing is this. Do you really think? You, first of all, we all seen Soulja Boy trained on Facebook. This man came in and left 5 pounds. He's as skinny as this microphone right here.
That boy has no coordination. I don't know what he was doing, but it's over. Okay, Obama is leaving as we are speaking right now. He is finished with his speech, so I'm going to have to watch that when I go home. So you got Chris Brown for the fight, correct?
Yeah, I got Chris Brown for the fight.
Chris Brown for the fight. Okay, moving on. Let's move on to another fight that went down last night. Alabama and Clemson. Woo! Okay. All right. I'm sorry. He's emotional. He's emotional from last night. Alabama and Clemson went on to take on the championship. Clemson, 35-31. That was a game.
I feel you, Mr. Lee, behind the glass.
But certain people, as you see, certain people are in their feelings right now because Alabama did not do what they were supposed to do last night. Jalen Hurts overthrowing people. Bo Scarborough, he did his thing, but he's not just a one-man team. And the defense, they just let Clemson come back on them in that second half. So I don't know. I don't know what to say or to do. It's to say just Alabama, try again, try harder. 35-31, Clemson takes the championship. First in a lot of years. They haven't won since 1981. So, yeah, it's been a long journey. You're on my headphone and you're about to snatch me down.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. So, yeah, Alabama, Clemson, 35-31.
It's all right.
It's okay. Moving on. And I hope you out of your feelings.
Yeah,
you okay?
Yeah.
You breathing?
Yeah.
Because we're moving on to the NFL playoffs. Wildcard weekend. It's finished. We have got our teams that are going on. All home court advantage teams. It's going to be a hell of a game Saturday and Sunday. Saturday, we got who is supposed to be going on? I think it's Houston and New England, they play the night game, of course. I ain't really worried about that. And I forget who the day game is.
And this is...
Seattle and Atlanta and for the day game on Saturday.
And this is how you know that game is worthless for you to watch, for your team to watch this shit.
I'm not going to be really concerned until we get to the AFC Championship. Because I already know who we're playing in the AFC Championship.
But you're going to watch. What you going to watch?
I'm definitely going to watch the games. I love football. I watch all games.
Why would you waste your time watching that? Because we all know who's going to win.
Because football is on. Why would I waste my time? Because football. I love football.
I mean, for you, it's going to be enjoyable. For every Patriots, people who hate the Patriots, we all gonna be sitting there like, I'm not watching this bullshit.
Y'all are watching because y'all gonna comment on every little thing that sucks about it, because that's what y'all look for every time the Patriots play. But during the day, Seattle and Atlanta play. They will be going for who you got?
Seattle and who?
Seattle and Atlanta.
I got Seattle. I got Seattle.
You got Seattle.
I got Seattle. Damn, because you know it's crazy. I play damn it, Fresh. Oh my god, I forgot he's a pitcher.
Forgot Fresh was a pitcher.
Oh my god, matter of fact, I ain't coming over no more. I'm not watching a fight over there no more. I'm not watching a fight over there.
So you got Seattle.
I got Seattle. Okay, yes, sir. Okay. I got Seattle.
I kind of agree with that one. So I'm going on Sunday games are going on. Pittsburgh is up against Kansas City Chiefs.
Mm-hmm. Who I got?
And then
game?
Who you got in that game?
I got Kansas City.
You got Kansas City?
I got Kansas City.
You know, that would not be a shocker to me if Kansas City sees us in the AFC Championship.
I got Kansas City. I'm going to tell you why. I got Kansas City because I need anybody to beat Pittsburgh.
Anybody.
Oh, I'm still that wound from Baltimore, that Christmas game hurts, boy.
Yeah, I feel you. I forgot how you feel about the Pittsburgh.
Oh, I hate them with a passion.
And then, last but not least, on Sunday... Are y'all the Sunday night game?
Yes, we are.
Okay, Sunday night game. Sunday night football. It goes down, and that is the game that I'm actually waiting for. Dallas Cowboys in their home will go down against the Green Bay Packers. It'll go all down right then and there. That's going to be a hell of a game. If it goes down the way I see it in my eyes and my vision, that's going to be the hell. That's going to be the divisional game of the week.
I am upset.
What?
About one game. The Packers and the Giants, right?
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to see the Giants. But the question I got for you is this.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that all that partying that the Giants did
mm-hmm.
came back at home?
Yeah, it probably did. Because the one thing that pissed me off about that game, and Lee said it best, is the fact that the Giants didn't even show up.
Mm-hmm.
they didn't even show up to that game. Like, they did not even put up a fight for that game. Like, I mean, y'all could have at least gave Green Bay something to do. Except
for they did.
Whatever.
They killed them.
Y'all rather go back to your locker rooms and bang your head up against the wall act all stupid and willy-nilly. That boy threw a temper tantrum if it was one.
He's a kid. Like, I don't trust nobody with a head that look like ramen noodles.
Yeah, he needs to cut that.
He looked like a top. That.
I mean, if you're going to bleach it, you need to take care of your hair when you bleach it. But
I'm not taking away, you know, him as a player. He's a great player. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But my thing is this. You party after you win the Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
You don't party during. That's how you know they're not champions.
So who you got in the Green Bay, New York, Green Bay Dallas game? Sorry.
Don't ask me no stupid ass questions.
I'm just asking. I have to ask.
Hold on. I'm going to give you my answer. Lee, real quick. Show your screen real quick. Come back to us. That's who I got.
Okay. All right.
That's all. No worries. I don't need to say.
Other three games. I got to ask for that one. So, yes. Okay. So, he has Dallas. I haven't decided yet. I'm undecided.
What do you mean you undecided? What do you mean you undecided?
I'm undecided right now. I am undecided at this point because if it goes down the way I'm thinking it's going to go down, that's going to be one hell of a game, and I don't know yet.
Dallas, that's all you got to remember.
That's all I'm saying. I just don't know.
That's all you need to know.
But that is entertainment news. That was a lot of entertainment news.
You've been working.
That was a lot of entertainment news. There was a lot to go off of, you know?
This is what I'm going to say to you.
So there.
First of all, Congratulations. You I gotta give you a an applause because I give you that. You've been working over the past 6 days, ladies and gentlemen. Lola has been working for this entertainment news. Most of it happened 2 days in advance, but it is what it is, man. Yes. But nah, thank you, Lola, for entertainment news. Before we go on commercial break, let's shout out everybody that's watching.
Let's do it. So we got Fresh in the building. We see Graciela. She's on Gracie. Here. I see Brandon. I saw Deidre. Paul is on there. Janae is on there. Rochelle, we see you on there. I saw Joy at one point. I don't know if she's still on there or not, but I did see Joy on there. And that was about it. Darnell was on there. Mm-hmm. Jordan was on there at one point.
Jordan was on there.
He was on there. I saw him. Yeah. He was on there. But yeah, so shout out to everybody that's tuning in right now with us. So now you don't have an excuse because Obama is off.
Thank you. not against my president. That will forever always be my president. Shout out to the first family.
Definitely.
But I have a question. Yeah. And I'm
yes, before your question, happy birthday to Fresh. Today he is celebrating his birthday.
Who?
Fresh,
happy birthday, yes, man.
Fresh. Happy birthday, player. I told him I was going to give him a birthday shout out. So, happy birthday to Fresh. He's celebrating. He's 56.
No, seriously. No, bullshit. Hold on, let me stop the music for this shit. Hold on.
He's 56 years old today. Congratulations. I know he's at home spending it with his children.
He's 56 for real? Or are you just lying?
I'm lying.
Oh, my God. I was like, damn, he look young.
Let me put it out. Happy 56. There you go. Happy 56.
Damn. Now I say, bruh.
Yes.
You too vegan?
But yeah, okay. So
that's a lot of water you've been drinking, brother.
Right, that's milk.
That's Merc. That's that soy.
That's Merc.
That's almond. All right, so before we go on commercial break, I want to leave this question up to Facebook. I'm going to look at this camera right now. You know the song Bad and Bougie by Migos. Bad and Bougie. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. Everybody has definitely been, you know, talking about their Bad and Bougie now. Chime in on me with me, Facebook. What's your real true definition of being bad and bougie?
No, bougie, period.
Bougie?
Bougie.
You want to be bougie?
Bougie.
Hold on. I got you.
Okay.
Let them do what they do. Okay. Let them come on and comment. Good.
We're
going to take 30-second commercial break. But think about it. I need y'all real true definition of what it means to be bad and bougie. And like, really, like, can men be bad and bougie as well?
Graciela, long all
right,
off, long
30
off.
Seconds. We'll be right back. That's what I'm saying. Oh, we'll be clear.
You want to see my inbox?
Okay. We're back. Get Loose Radio. Mm-hmm. Get Loose Radio, the hottest show on WTTS Radio. You dig? All right, I posed a question for my Facebook viewers. Thank you guys for tuning in. I really do appreciate y'all. I really do. But I want to ask y'all. Migos, they have a song that's out right now. Very, very popular song that's out right now. It's called Bad and Bougie. Mm-hmm. I want to know, what's your real true definition of being bad and bougie? But and before we went on commercial break, my ace boom coon, Scottie Pippen over here, she just was about to just go off and I had to tell her to calm down calm down. We'll be right to, I'm going right to you when we come back, okay? She basically just said, fuck y'all, and she just want to do whatever. But anyway, no, I'm sorry. Lola.
Yeah. Oof. No, what I was going to say before the break was just to define bougie. Because I'm sure, just like me, there are people that are on this feed right now that have been called bougie. Mm-hmm. And it was in a bad way.
Well, let me ask you a question. What's your definition of being bougie? How about that?
My definition, or the definition that has been bestowed upon me? Because it's two different things. To me, bougie means that you have standards. Okay. And there's a level that you will not go below.
Okay.
You know, for instance, you know, I will not go outside without my hair done.
Okay.
Ponytail or something like that. You will never see me hair all willy-nilly and out that stuff like that.
Okay.
That's a level. That's a standard.
Mm-hmm.
But the definition that has been bestowed upon me is that I'm stuck up. I'm uppity. You know, I'm just too good for everybody. You know, I think I'm better than other people and everything like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that's two different definitions for me.
Okay. Let me ask you a question. Everybody wants to be bad and bougie now, right? So it's popular to be bougie now, right?
Mm.
What happened back in the day?
That's what I'm saying. All of a sudden, here now, all of a sudden, you sprinkle a little bad in there, and all of a sudden, bougie becomes the trend to be now.
Like
Graciela said, most of y'all hoes is broken basic, so I don't understand how y'all gonna be bad and bougie.
She's still on the feed?
Yes, she is. She's still going on. Jizzle has popped up in the feed.
Jizzle!
He says, bad and bougie means being bad, which means cute, sexy, hot, attractive, and bougie meaning you don't take nothing less than your standards and curving the phony and fake before they run game.
True.
Now, I could take that definition.
I ain't wrong.
So it's like, just like everything in this generation, they take the old definition, just like the Running Man Challenge, they switch it up, they put a new spark on it, and all of a sudden, everybody bad and bougie.
All of a sudden. All it takes is one little song. Is it cool for a man to be bougie?
Graciela, be quiet. I can tell you which one, but not on live feed.
Oh, I see. Never
mind. Yeah, she said, sweetheart had told me that. I'll tell you later, boo. Deidre, she chimed in. She says, I mean, there is a whole book that breaks down the bourgeois. It is, and it's called Our Kind of People, Inside America's Black Upper Class. I've actually seen that documentary, The 1% of the upper class blacks.
Mm-hmm.
It's really good. It's really good. You think we bougie. Whoop! Nope.
Okay. Now, let me tell you something. I worked at the bank.
Mm-hmm.
I worked at Enterprise.
Mm-hmm.
I hated both jobs. Put that out there right now. I can't stand them jobs, but I love the perks, especially with Enterprise. The clientele that we had coming in here drove a Mercedes-Benz, drove BMWs, drove Audis, you know what I'm saying? Had pretty decent jobs.
Mm-hmm.
Got the nerve to be bougie when requesting a car.
Mm-hmm.
My thing is this, though. You're not qualified to be bad or bougie if your salary is at least 60K. Okay, I'm gonna put that out there right now. That's just my opinion. Okay, you have to, and then, you know, I look up your address, bruh, you live in Cockeysville. You live in Randallstown, my nigga. You live in Owens Mills, bruh. Newtown area. That's not bougie, bruh. I could take you to some places where you be sitting there looking at them like, oh my God, like mansions around the Lutherville, Timonium era, but like deep inside. Like that. That's what she said. But, you know, that's, you know what I'm saying? But, like, I think people do take the definition of being bougie all the way wrong. Now, can a man be bougie?
Can a man be bougie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How?
I mean, yeah, y'all can. And another definition, another way to call y'all, metrosexual. Period. Y'all might call it bougie. Some people call it metrosexual, but and any regret. That's what y'all are.
Okay.
But, you know, women will, a man that cleans himself up, takes care of his appearance, won't settle for just some round away girl. They're called boys. Would I bestow that definition on him? Oh, no. I just say that that's a man that knows what he wants.
But that's what I'm saying. I don't think a man can be bougie. I think a man, he's at least... A man can... Men, we do have certain... We do have
Jay-Z standards. Is bougie. Just saying. Jay-Z is bougie.
Okay, how long have you known me? How long have you known me?
Have I known you? Oh, gosh. Since, what, 12?
Since 12, right?
Yeah, since 2012.
Going on, it'll be 5 years, March. Mm-hmm. I remember that, because that's when we was Enterprise.
Yeah, that was around the time that me and Janae went to see Trey Song. Yeah, right, so March.
Mm-hmm. Right, okay. Out of 5 years that you know me, Facebook, everybody who know me on Facebook, shut up. Do you think I'm bougie?
Do I think you're bougie? Mm-hmm. I think you have tendencies.
How?
What you mean? Like, how?
Yes, how?
Okay, let me, okay, when you travel,
okay,
would you stay at a motel?
Hell no.
Bougie.
Hell no. What the hell I look like laying on the couch? What the hell I look like laying on the couch and I got a cockroach laying next to me?
That's what I'm saying. To my definition, you have a standard that you won't go below.
Okay, okay.
So, but you move.
All right, what else? Give me something else.
All right, is there a certain drink that you will only drink? Or will you just drink anything? Will you take cheap vodka?
Why would I throw up? Why would I want to throw up?
Bougie.
I ain't throwing up over no Burnett.
I'm not even going to say bougie. I'm going to say standard. There's a standard.
There we go.
With women, can a woman have an ass and titties and that's it and you will still fuck? Or does she have to be cute in the face? And have to be smart. Have to hold a conversation. Have to have an education. Knows what the fuck she's talking about and have goals in life. Or will you just take any random smoker coming out the back?
You read a Libra's horoscope with all that, what you just said,
right?
No,
I didn't. No, I didn't. Yes or no? Don't try to explain it. Yes or no? Yes or no?
She got to have all that. You're right.
Standard. You're right. A standard. When you walk out the house, do you look in your closet and say, nope, that don't match. Nope.
Depends. It depends.
It depends on where you're going, right? If you're going out with the fellas on a night, smoke cigars or whatever like that, will you wear just anything? Will you walk out the house with just anything on it? Would you actually go look in the mirror and look at yourself and say, oh, okay, yeah, gotta put the oil on my beard, brush my hair, iron my shirt, throw on some cologne.
Who the hell you been talking to?
Standard. Y'all gonna stop this. Y'all gonna stop acting like men don't have
standards. Okay, men, okay.
Some men, no, boys don't have standards. Boys
okay,
will walk
I love the look
and
good.
Just do any damn thing. A man will walk out and be like, okay, yeah, I get it.
I got to look shout out to Brittany Holmes, you know, who just checked in. What's up, girl? What's up, Britt? What's up, girl? What are these people saying?
Okay, so here we go.
When
he had them shorts on, that left his chest.
We ain't gonna talk about you in shorts. Let's not talk about you in shorts, Graciela. Let's not talk about you in shorts, Graciela.
Yeah, on that leather jacket.
Got two wagons trapped.
Janae says Jordan has high standards. You have high standards, so you can sit here and act like you so down, you so from the hood, and all this other stuff. You have high standards, buddy. Thank you. Leave behind the glass is the MVP. Jordan is cheap and bougie.
First of all, I don't know who Jordan is.
Not bad and bougie.
I don't know who's Jordan
GDJ,
is.
GDJ.
Oh shit.
Cheap and bougie. Cheap and bougie. So there. Cheap and bougie. There you go. So there. Deidre says, hell yeah, especially if his parents raised him that way. Ooh. Boop!
Well, if you knew who my parents are, they don't walk out the house looking any old type of way.
And what makes you think that you would?
I just call it proper excellent upbringing.
Let's just settle this.
What does the Bible say? Train a child
Okay.
You know, so the rest of
we'll settle this right now. This is how you know if you got a bougie persona. If you walk out the house and your parents say, get your black ass back in that house and put something on presentable, you bougie. Because your parents is not going to let you walk out the house just looking all types of who shot John. Your parent wouldn't, my mama damn sure wouldn't let me walk out the house looking like whoever.
You embarrass me out in public. Mm-mm. You embarrass
me. You embarrass me.
When you walk out that door, you represent me.
Exactly.
When you walk out that door, you represent your last name. You better take pride of your last name. So I'll take, okay.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
Janae is definitely bad and bougie. That's my book. I love it. Bad and bougie. That's right.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to ask you the same question.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you the same question.
Okay.
Is Lola bougie?
Ask that question one more time.
I'm asking because I he asked me, I'm going to ask him, is Lola bougie?
Mr. Lee behind the glass. Here's my answer. Mr. Lee behind the glass. Back to me. You really want my answer?
Yes, I want
to. Fuck yeah, you bougie. You one of the bougiest people I've ever met in my damn life. Fresh food. Not fresh fries. Fresh food. Your first date, from what I understood, for your the dream, like a when I first met you, the fantasy date was you gotta take me to an Italian restaurant. You know what I'm saying? You have to pick me up with flowers. You have to carry me. Damn near carry you by the damn car and whatnot. You are bougie as fuck.
I have standards. Praise the Lord.
You have. Praise the Lord.
You You pick me up for a date. You walk out the fucking house. What is he talking about?
Don't worry about it.
You rather me. Let you pick me up. Don't open up no damn door.
Okay, hold on. That's called being a gentleman.
But some people don't.
That's called being a gentleman. Thank you. That's called being a gentleman. But you, my lady.
What?
Partner in crime, ace of spades.
What?
You are bougie.
And?
What does Janae say about this? Since we getting Janae on everything, what does Janae say about this?
Forget y'all.
Fuck that. What Brandon say about this, bruh? I got like two other dudes in here that definitely agree with me. Fellas, anybody that know me, that know Lo, bruh, Jenny know Lo bougie. You are bougie as all hell. But you know what though? I'd rather you to be bougie, to be hoey and slutty, okay? Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong with being bougie. I'd rather take that.
But see, that's what I said. In my terms, bougie means you have stands. And yes, I have a stand. If you want to take me out on a date, then yeah, you're going to have to pay. So that rules you out.
Yeah, well.
That rules you out completely because you cheat. You got to open doors.
I open doors.
You open doors?
I open doors. I open doors for almost every
female. Okay, and you have to have some kind of, you got to have some kind of category of food besides burgers and fries.
Oh, yeah, you ain't got to worry about
and
that.
And pizza. See, and for, hot wings.
Well, hold on.
I don't want to go to no sports bar on no first damn date unless we're in the playoffs.
No, we don't.
Unless we're in the playoffs. But on a first date, seriously?
Hold on, time out. This is what I'm gonna say, and I'm gonna drop it. So, if you're in the playoffs, hey, bruh, I'm gonna let you know right now. Every time y'all go out, it's the first date. They're in the playoffs.
Thank you, Graciela. Not Olive Garden. If you take me to Olive Garden, when I say take me to an Italian restaurant, we fighting.
Maggiano's.
All right, that's a step up.
It's another Italian restaurant around the DC area. What is it called? It's expensive. That's how you know I don't remember. Okay. Let me say this. So let me say this about myself, okay? Only a select few, and when I say select few, meaning one, has actually experienced me not being cheap. Mm-hmm. Okay. I have definitely put out some money. And the relationship didn't work. Whatever. It lasted for about 4-5 years, maybe. Whatever. And I kept every receipt. Okay. I keep my receipt. I keep my receipt as if I keep my receipts for my taxes, okay? For cleaning bills and all that other shit. But no, travel expenses, T&E. Hello.
Okay, we get it.
But no. I would definitely put out bread for certain people, certain women, okay? Meaning when I say certain women, you have to be my girl in order for you to understand, you know what I'm saying? You know, for you to understand how given I can really be. All y'all other motherfuckers, kiss my ass.
No Carrabba's.
No. No, not Carrabba's.
No Carrabba's.
I told my ex, I said, look, and we still friends to this day. I said, you know, you pick where you want to go, the location, because it's our anniversary. You know, I don't care what it is. She said, okay. She picked the location and she got the nerve. This heifer got the nerve to want to do a hotel. And all this shit was in D.C. Uh-huh. I was just like, okay. And I dropped some bread on her. I did not care. It is what it is. But hey, I did it for her. If we not official, you're not going to get that shit. Now, courting, when we court, I'll open up a door for you. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. I'll, you know. Shit, you know, it is what it is. I'll take you to a nice little 3-star restaurant, you know. Hey.
Three. You know Olive Garden.
Golden Corral.
That
Cactus Willie's when it was still open, I'll take you there.
Olive Garden is 3 stars.
We ain't dating, so we ain't gotta worry about shit, okay?
Red Robin is 3. Red Robin is 3 stars.
But my thing is this. No, seriously. My thing is this, though.
This ass said low noodle and company. Brandon, shut up.
It's okay.
Now, wait a minute now. He said Starbucks.
Mr. Lee behind the glass. Look how many stars Starbucks really got. And May got 2.
Anything involving Starbucks, I'm there. But no, I mean, okay, first dates, okay, whatever. You can do what you want to do. It doesn't matter, you know.
No, first dates, but no, my thing is this. My family always taught me first impression is a lasting impression. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? First dates, I will definitely I'll go out my way and really treat, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. When we're together, I would definitely treat my woman like she's a queen. Mm-hmm. If we just talking, ain't nothing going nowhere. And it's a thing. It's a reason why I'll take you to maybe a 2-3 star. Because if the date is not going the way, you know, I thought it was going to go, at least I could walk away saying, number one, I ain't drop a lot of money. Mm-hmm. I have nothing to worry about. Mm-hmm. We good to go. It is what it is.
So, okay. So describe a good date. A good first date. Describe a good date. And it better not have Red Lobster. Corral in there or nothing.
No.
Describe a good date.
Okay, hold on. Okay. Let me really think about this.
Because, I mean, I'm just saying, because y'all saying that we over here, we bougie. So, you know, what should we go for?
Let me upgrade you real quick.
First
date with Jiggy. First date with Jordan. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna give y'all my whole government name. It is what it is. First date with Jordan. Pick you up from your house. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I would definitely make sure that I would do my research by asking you questions. You know,
prior
to the date. Flowers. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. In terms of where you want to go, all this other stuff.
Right.
So I will give you the flowers that you want. I will walk you to the passenger's door to my car. I will open it, make sure you are tucked in pretty well, like you're going to bed tucked in. I'll close the door, and I will walk my black ass around to that driver's side. Uh-huh. Great casual conversation going towards, you know, our destination. Mm-hmm. We having a good conversation. We talking. It is what it is. We get from point A to point B, point C to point D. I pay for the bill. During that conversation, it has to be some flirting involved, because after when we're done, I'm expecting a G GTD moment.
Oh my lord.
Do you know what GTD stands for?
I'm not even
kidding. Got
the draw.
There you go.
Okay.
It has to be a GTD moment. Because all that work I'm putting in, I better get a whiff of some pussy, okay? Now, I don't want whiff pussy. I'm going to get a whiff of some nice pussy, okay?
Some whiff.
Yes.
Graciela says you would heat up a cup of doodles.
And she still ate it, so it don't matter. Oh, I had a good comeback. Nope.
No, honestly, I think, and I'm with Deidre on this one. Shout out to Deidre. I'm on her with this one. The first date should at least be coffee or lunch. Brunch is a good idea. That way, it's still reasonable for the pockets, and it gives you a sense of what could be. So, if y'all go to dinner, naturally, if you spend all that money, you gonna want some ass. Like, let's go.
Yeah.
There's no requirement. Let's do this. I pay for drinks. I pay for appetizers. I pay for main course. I pay for dessert, flowers. I actually ironed my shirt. Oh, you gonna give me some ass tonight. So,
absolutely.
Naturally.
You gonna do the Humpty dance all night, okay? I'm not playing with y'all.
So yeah, I get it.
No, seriously. I mean, like, no, seriously. Like, it just whatever, man, you know?
Yeah.
But my girl, not my friend, my girl, she'll get that royalty treatment.
Well, naturally your woman should get all of that. Because if she's your woman, she deserves that.
Absolutely.
Right?
So absolutely. Now, do you believe, and ladies, this is for y'all too. Do you believe that men, we should have not only a day, but a time where y'all can court us, treat us like royalty? Because in my opinion, y'all really don't. You would do that.
No, I was about to say, because I
you do that.
I bet.
You do that. We do that. You do that, okay? But my thing is this. What did he say?
He said, don't put him in it. All right.
No, he only.
Guess I'll stand alone. All right.
Yeah, this is for y'all. Do y'all feel as though women don't do enough, though, for a man to do certain things like courting and really treating you like a queen on dates or whatnot? During a relationship and also, non-during relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that shit should still happen?
Yes. I don't think that it should be one-sided with the date. So if you are in a relationship, you should take time out to appreciate your man and show him some love. Yes. And I mean, show him some love. Like, don't just, you know.
How would you, don't give me specifics. Just paint the picture for the people as to how you would quote, you would court your man.
Well, you got to know your man, first of all. You got to know what he's into and what he likes and everything like that. So with me, if I know my man, I know what specific things would, brighten his day as far as, like if it's in sports season or if he wants to go to a game or what food he likes or if he wants a massage or, if he needs a haircut, just razzle-dazzle him a little bit. If he wants you to cook for him, if he likes your cooking, if he don't like your cooking, don't do that.
Some of y'all women should not be in the kitchen.
Yeah, he gonna think you trying to kill him or something like that. But you gotta know what your man likes and what he's into, and that will guide you to how you give him a day to himself or how you take him out on the city and do things like that. Definitely do. And Deidre says that's a lopsided relationship if she can't do that for her dude, though. So,
but women,
yeah.
Y'all expecting more than some women expecting more than that.
Yeah, but don't do all that and then when he wants you to turn it on, y'all just.
You shut down.
I'm tired. It was a long day.
Hold on. Is Mama Jefferson on here?
Yes, she did. Mama Lisa. Red shoes and damn.
This would be the perfect time for her.
Yes, throw the red pumps on. Throw the red pumps on. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You better give it, this is outfit. You better give that man a Janet Jackson performance. Yeah. When he had the dude chained.
Man. If you own a house, build a pole in your basement. Boy. Just saying.
Depending on how big your basement is, you better.
Or your bedroom. Some people, I have a friend who has a pole in her bedroom. Like, she installed it into her, you know, the structure of the house. Damn, so it's not one of them flimsy ass one where you jump up there and it goes to the side. No, that beverage is installed into the structure of the house. So when you grab it, it's there. It's gripped. You know what type of woman I want
to do that? If I'm going to get a pole in my bedroom, ain't no if, when I get a pole in my bedroom, I'm going to pause the music on this one. I want her to be so damn talented. You know, I'm going with this. Uh-huh. She climbs all the way to the top of this pole.
Oh, it does a
sailor,
split?
It does a split on the sailor. I want all that. I want her to walk. And flip and twerk.
You know how much practice that takes?
She better get going.
Now, I've been to a couple of pole class dances. That's practice. I mean, that takes a lot of structure and strength and core to get up there, climb all the way up there, do the split and hold yourself. Yeah, that takes a lot of structure.
If you out there, get to work. Okay. All right.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Well, look, y'all. Unfortunately, I didn't realize what time it was. It's 10:32. It's the end of our show. But once again, we want to thank everybody who tuned in to the show. We really do appreciate every you know, as much support that we can possibly get. And mm-hmm. I'm telling you this right now, love. Ever since we launched the new fan page for Get Loose Radio, you felt that? The response has been overwhelming, man. Everybody has liked the page. Whoa. Everybody is part of the page. What's Whoa, wrong? What's
I'm
wrong?
Sorry.
What's
wrong? I'm missly saying. Oh, my Lord.
What's she say?
She said blindfold whip, peanut butter, and peaches. She's a VM. She's an MVP. You go ahead, Miss Lee saying. Now I know where Jermaine get it from.
You so nasty.
Nasty.
You so nasty.
Nasties. I know we're good. Shout out to Jermaine and Brandon, because I know,
well, we all know how Jermaine
that ideas
here.
Took.
We all know how Jermaine got here.
They got Eli. So, yeah.
Hey, dog.
Anyway, thank you so much for tuning in with us. And yes, back to our fan page.
Like I said, thank
you so much.
Mama Logoff. Mama Lazan. Mama Jefferson Logoff. You just threw me way off. Bruh, you better not be calling my mama. You better not be calling my mama. No. Matter of fact, call her. Boy, she gonna rip a new one in you. Boy, I'm trying to tell you, she crazy.
Oh, Lord.
Anyway, hold on. Let me get back. Right. We really do appreciate you guys liking the page. Like I said, Lo, we received a tremendous amount of responses. My mama got me all messed up.
I know, but peanut butter.
Peanut butter, damn. She won't be sticky. That's
my
mama.
That's a sticky situation.
Anyway, that's a sticky situation. Jiffy?
Honey.
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 Anyway, focus, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm sorry.
We really thank you guys for definitely liking and joining the page. Ooh. No, don't read it. We got a lot of things in store. What'd she say?
She said her number is.
No! Janae, get mama.
We got a lot of feedback on the Get Loose page, and it is amazing. That's amazing. Thank you guys so much for everything, and keep sharing and liking the page. Share it to your friends or on your page and everything, because it's getting out there. Get Loose Radio is becoming...
It's becoming a hit.
Yeah, it's getting big.
I'm going to tell y'all this right now. The things that I got in store for this radio show, man, we have been working hard. Shout out to Mr. Lee Behind the Glass for the production. Shout out to my ace, Lola, who's definitely been, you know, very instrumental and, you know, in what she does, especially for the news that she gives y'all. Shout out to my marketing team who I've been working closely with to making sure, you know, this happens, man. Also, if you don't know, I'm announcing one more time. We have always been on YouTube, but Get Loose Radio is on YouTube, man. If you miss any show, you can just go back. Just type, go to youtube.com, go to that search bar, just type in Get Loose Radio, all them episodes will pop up. Trust me. And you will definitely not be sorry. Also, we're on SoundCloud too, man. All you gotta do, just download the app. download the app. You can listen to it. We're on podcast radio, man. And trust me, you know, you'll definitely be able to hear all the shows. I'm going to put this show on there when we're done. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to put the first show on there last week.
It's already on there.
It's already on there.
Yes.
Shout out to my marketing team.
It's already on
there. Damn, they working, man. I appreciate the. Definitely. I appreciate y'all all so much. Just get ready, man. Get Loose Radio. We got something big for y'all. I got a guest coming in next week. It's a nonprofit organization. He wants to definitely share with us as to what he got going on in Baltimore that I'm also a part of as well. Mm-hmm. Get ready. Get Loose Radio. This show ain't for everybody.
But it's for somebody.
It's for everybody, it's man. For everybody. I'm going to tell y'all right now, thank you guys. Where's the song? Thank you guys from the bottom of our hearts. We really do appreciate it. For Mr. Lee behind the glass, to Phil Jackson, the coach of the show, man. We appreciate you, bruh. Thank you, my fellow cowboy. I'd like to thank my marketing team. Thank you guys so much. I'd like to thank the fans. But I'd like to thank my sidekick, my ace. Ace Boone Coon, Ms. Lola Moss, thank you so much.
You did.
And also the GOAT, the greatest voice in radio, I must so say myself. I'm kind of a little arrogant because it's my stuff, man. It's my thing, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate y'all for tuning in, man. We'll see y'all next week, 10:30. Oh, Jesus. 9:30. 9:30.
Pushing it back?
I'm looking at
Trump
the time.
Trump pushing everybody back, ain't he?
We see y'all 9:30 next week, ladies and gentlemen.
Bye, guys.
Peace.